aggression and cage control heading into this fight. There have been 102 fights in Invicta FC. Exactly half, 51 of them have ended inside the distance. 51 finishes, 24 knockouts, 20 submissions. That means to me, Julie, that you always know you're going to get your money's worth from an Invicta FC fight. The aggression, these ladies always put it on the line, knowing that they are competing against the very best, their peers here in Invicta FC. And Ostovich and Johnson in a bit of a feeling out process again, trying to get rid of those jitters. Beautiful straight nice right hand down the middle by Ostovich. A 1-2 combination from the Hawaiian. There's the tie clinch from the taller Johnson and a knee to the breadbasket.
Yeah, it's kind of interesting to see them moving at each other cautiously, but a little bit like veterans. You can see the training and the experience they've had in their amateur career coming to play here. Nice inside leg kick.
Ostovich wearing the Wonder Woman outfit as she sprawls and immediately takes the back, but then slides off the back of Johnson. Ostovich sporting the Wonder Woman colors, but you can't use that lasso of truth in the cage, but this is the cage of truth, and as we all know, the truth can sometimes hurt, and right now she's pinned up along the fence as Johnson changes levels, really trying to sink in that double leg takedown.
She is, and you can see the wrestling experience in the defense coming from Ostovich. The way she shucked that arm over, Johnson's trying very, very hard for those legs, but Ostovich is doing a pretty good job defending that off the cage.
Doing a very good job of thwarting the takedown attempt thus far. Now moving to the away from the fence as they jostle for position. Two minutes have elapsed here in our first of three rounds, and it looks like it was Ostovich attempting an Uchimata. Instead, she's taken down, and now it's Johnson on the back looking for that rear naked choke.
Yeah, that was a really nice read of that lateral trip off the back.
She wanted to flatten out Ostovich. Back mount, Ostovich looking for the backdoor escape, and now it's Johnson going for the armbar. And a beautiful escape by Ostovich. Good stuff early on.
I love it, sir.
I need that straight right.
Midway point of the opening round. Johnson unable to read the range there. She misses, but then delivers the outside low kick to the lead leg of Ostovich.
Yeah, look at the way Ostovich turns her left foot in. It does open her up for some pretty hard leg kicks from Johnson, but Johnson is unable kind of to get the distance on landing those with power right now.
Left hand connects, overhand right by Ostovich, and then able to connect with a few punches as she splits Johnson's guard. Again, Johnson missing with the left hand, unable to close the distance. You hear the corner talk about closing that distance.
I'd like to see a little bit more commitment in punches from Johnson.
Well, Ostovich is committed to that combination.
Yes, she has.
And again, that overhand right by Ostovich is there now in the clinch. And Johnson and Ostovich again able to turn away, separate, and take it back to the center of the cage. Under a minute remaining in our first of eight fights coming your way tonight at Invicta FC 10. This is in the flyweight division. Two Invicta FC newcomers in Rachael Ostovich in the Wonder Woman colors and No Fear Eva Johnson, 29-year-old out of Lexington, Kentucky. And I gotta say, Ostovich, her family in attendance tonight and getting a lot of support from Hawaii via social media, and Hawaii really does love its fighting. Of course, you look back at the rich heritage of fighting on the islands and BJ Penn, the prodigy, and now Ostovich finds herself in half guard, the on top position from Johnson's half guard.
You can see there Johnson moving up to a high guard position on there, trying again, probably trying for an armbar or triangle attempt there.
sustained a period with Ostovich in top position. Johnson, of course, did go for that armbar, which Ostovich was able to extricate herself from as we begin the second round in this flyweight matchup. Outside low kick and then a flicking front kick there from Johnson, and again doesn't find the range though. She has to do a much better job of closing the gap if she wants to throw those strikes.
She does. She's doing a much better job. Well, she's in close now, but she was doing a much better job when she was defending by trying to grab at kicks of Ostovich.
Ostovich with the wizard, both of them trying to pummel here.
And you can see Evis trying to drag her down to the ground a little bit, trying that lateral trick once more.
Balance, and there's that strength of Ostovich, and again able to stop that takedown and be in this position, pushing, oh, a knee to the face by Ostovich. And there's the power. Ostovich just muscling Johnson to the canvas.
Yeah, doing a very, very good job of reading those takedown attempts and then, you know, countering them with her power. She's got great hips.
And cross-facing Johnson. Johnson wanting to reverse and sweep, and now looking for that.
Looking for an outside heel hook, looks like.
Yeah, right, looking there for that submission. Ostovich doesn't appear to be.
No, I don't think the leverage is there with her knee.
No, and she is very calm and cool. Under fire, showing a lot of maturity here. The 23-year-old in her third professional fight, now going to town on Johnson with those right hands. And she continues to fire away at no fear Eva Johnson, who's in a turtle position now, trying to defend, trying to thwart the attack. Now she's got her back. Julian's got the hook.
She is, and she's flattening her out, or attempting to flatten her out, which is a smart strategy in order to get that submission. Looks like she's going to attempt an armbar here.
And that's how she recorded her last victory, was via armbar against Misha Nasiri in September of this year. Now, under 3 minutes remaining in the second round. Johnson in the on her back. And Ostovich just kicking away. I'm sure the referee's going to scan Johnson up here momentarily if we don't see more action. Shogun Hua was always dangerous from this position standing, back in the Pride days especially.
It would add some dimension if they were doing soccer kicks to the head.
Yeah, just even flying through the guard with a right hand. Fedor Emelianenko also very good from this position, and the referee really allowing Johnson to just continue to pivot off her back. And I don't know, if I was Ostovich, wouldn't
I would probably step back and let her get back up
to her
feet. But she is racking up points, and she's making herself look very, very dominant right here. Eva's, you know, the butt scooting game, she's not doing it ineffectively. She's able to get to her feet with it.
2 minutes left in the second round.
Oh,
there's that beautiful
right
1-2
here
combination by Ostovich. Body kick by the Hawaiian. Johnson throwing out the left, but not a lot of pop to her strikes. It's almost like her will may be broken a bit by Ostovich, as Johnson unable to really commit. Although, again, she gets in the clinch, and she's shown in the past that she's proficient from this position.
She is proficient from this position, but I would like to see a little bit more action, a little bit more power for her. It's like she's kind of not committing to her shots right there.
Now Ostovich there.
Oh, very nicely done.
Aregoshi there, the judo, the sweeping hip throw by Rachael Ostovich. And she continues to rack up points here in the second round.
And you can see the way Johnson's climbing her legs up, looking for those subs off of her back.
Under a minute left in the second round, and this time Ostovich does step back and allows Johnson to get back up to her vertical base, and Johnson comes in with the strikes, but again, unable to find the target. And meanwhile, Ostovich pops off the jab, misses with the right hand, but still gets the better of the striking exchange.
Yeah, she's doing a very, very good job of setting up her power shots. I mean, she did miss that one, but you can see from her movement, she's really settling on that right hand and setting it up well.
She went for the body kick, and the kick was caught by Johnson, who is looking for the signal, maybe trying to sweep that post leg.
Oh, beautiful! Sweep
by Ostovich!
That was really, really well done. You don't see that very often.
Creative move by Rachael Ostovich.
Now you can see the way Eva's going for that heel hook and figure fouring her legs like that, trying to make it hard for Ostovich to get out. Ostovich is rolling, is doing an effective way of stopping the leverage of that.
The bell and round three. They touch gloves. Johnson missing with that lead left, now connecting, but standing straight up.
She's trying to throw an overhand line. So right. Good, they got more of it. Come on, stay active.
Ostovich circling to her right away from a beautiful lead right uppercut, followed by the left hand. The best combination of the fight by Ostovich.
Yeah, the problem that's going on right here is there's not a lot of commitment on those punches coming from Johnson. She really, really needs to kind of step forward, push her hips a little bit more into that right hand.
Oh, spinning back fist. It just grazed the face of Johnson, but you can see that Ostovich here in her Invicta FC debut wanting to make a good first impression. But here in the third round, I think both of them need to start taking a few more chances. We know it's their debut. We know the nerves are there, but now it's some, oh, you have to be careful. Those 12 to 6 elbows are illegal. And I agree with Joe Rogan, they shouldn't be.
Oh,
takedown
another lateral
by
attempt.
Johnson, but look at Ostovich again, able to distribute her weight, her balance.
Eva's attempting to climb on her back right there. She's trying to climb up while Johnson's doing a good job of posting on all four and maintaining top position. Yeah, the right thing to do right here is to try and flatten her out. Now, with her knees in that position, Ostovich is in danger of being swept, but she's doing a very good job of pushing her weight back on her hips.
Now, standing up in the closed guard, or just a spider guard there momentarily by Johnson, but Ostovich remains in control here as we have passed the two-minute mark of the final frame. Arena Theater Houston, Invicta FC 10 just getting underway. A contest between two Invicta FC newcomers, Rachael Ostovich of Honolulu, Hawaii, No Fear Eva Johnson from Lexington, Kentucky. And you can see that they are still both in the maturation process as professional mixed martial artists. It seems like Ostovich is willing to take more of a risk, willing to make it more of a fight, but now she's backing up, flashes the jab. Johnson continues to come forward, but has been unable to really find the range, and as you said, Julie, not really committing to her shots.
No, I think she's much more comfortable on the ground. She's much more comfortable when she's fighting off of her back, as you can see right here, you know, climbing her legs up and getting on top of Ostovich's back. You know, I think she's definitely, the ground is her element in this fight.
And she'll have to capitalize if that's the case here. Has her best position, has the hooks in on the back mount, will be fishing for the rear naked choke, softening Ostovich up first of all, or trying.
Yeah, if I were her right now, I would be trying to hit her as much as possible, try to flatten her out. Ostovich is doing a good job with that balance. You can see she's fighting with her legs, trying to get her legs free of those hooks so she can roll.
Try to get that back door escape potentially, but now hammer fist from the back, and she's got to be careful to not attack the back of Ostovich's head. Under 90 seconds left in the fight. Johnson in her first sustained dominant position here, trying to do damage, trying to somehow find a way to submit Rachael Ostovich.
Yeah, these are the times you want to go for broke as a fighter. When you're on somebody's back, you really, really need to get your hands free. You need to start just pounding them. Finding your position, getting your fighter to break underneath you so that you can go for those submissions.
Under a minute left in the fight, and Johnson has to become way more aggressive from this position. She has to know that she's behind on the scorecards. Again, has the back mount, and now look at the wide base by Ostovich.
That's an incredible balance we're seeing right there.
And that's the gymnastics. She told us that her background in cheerleading, judo, gymnastics, wrestling have prepared her for success in the Invicta FC cage. And as we near the 30-second mark left in this fight, those skills and that background may indeed be serving her well here in her Invicta FC debut, although Johnson continues to pepper away. But it's really a stalemate right now from this position.
You know, it kind of is. I wouldn't want the ref to break up such a dominant position for
no, not at all, but she's not doing enough.
There's not a lot happening here because of Ostovich's good base, because of the control that she has. She's not really entirely threatened right here unless Eva's able to free a hand and able to really start pounding those strikes out.
We're going to the judges' scorecards. 15 minutes down in our first fight of the night, and some good sportsmanship there as they both embrace. Rachael Ostovich and Eva Johnson go the distance here at Invicta FC 10.
Well, fight fans, after three rounds, we go to the judges, and here are the totals. Judge Moore has it 29-28 for Johnson. Judge Beltran, 29-28 for Ostovich. And Judge Zaragoza, 29-28 for your winner by split decision, Rachael Ostovich. And here we go, fight fans, the next bout tonight, three rounds in the flyweight division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner. She is a mixed martial artist standing 5'3" tall. Official weight, 125¾ pounds. As a professional, her record stands at 2 victories and 1 defeat. Fighting out of Honolulu, Hawaii, here is Wonder Woman, Rachael Ostovich. And next, her opponent across the cage, fighting out of the red corner. Her background is in Muay Thai and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. At 5'6" tall, she weighed officially 125 pounds. She too has a professional record in 3 bouts of 2 victories and 1 defeat. Fighting out of Bossier City, Louisiana, here is Andrea KGB Lee! Referee in charge, once again, is Big John McCarthy.
Referee John McCarthy getting this flyweight assignment. It is Andrea KGB Lee and Rachael Ostovich. Over there. Right. People have been talking about this fight since this card was announced, and here we go. We are underway. Touch of gloves. See where this fight takes place. On paper, you could say it's a striker versus a grappler, but both of these women, very well-rounded mixed martial artists.
They are very well-rounded, and I would say we're going to see some pretty good action here.
See Ostovich come in with a 1-2, wisely evaded by Lee. Nice kick there by Ostovich.
Ostovich has some heavy, heavy hands, but Lee's striking is just very, very elite.
Mention Ostovich specializes in judo. We'll see if she can benefit from a clinch here. Lee having none of it early.
Get up there, set up there fast and crisp. Snap the jab in. There you go, beautiful, beautiful. Keep it coming. Keep it coming. Fire behind that two.
Lee was training with Sharon Jacobson for this fight, so I have a feeling she's going to be working hard on shucking off clinch attempts.
Ostovich needs to be wise to that as well when she gets in the clinch trying to go for a head and arm throw. You can give up your back sometimes if you get too aggressive.
Too much posing, Andrew. Too much posing.
Lee firing off that jab.
There you go. Step left. Step left. Cut her off. Cut her off.
Look at the way Lee faints. She doesn't just faint with her head. Her whole body moves, so you really expect her to move one direction, then she moves the other. It's really nicely done. Very, very hard to gauge somebody's attack from that.
Ostovich pushing forward with a 1-2 that misses.
Pressure, Andrea. Don't forget about the body. Don't forget about the body.
Oh, nice body punch there by Lee. A corner was calling for it, and she delivered.
Oh, nice head kick.
Ostovich comes high with that right high kick. Now she goes to the body with the left. Lee stalking forward, fires off a left hand.
You can see that Ostovich is trying to get a read on her. She can't quite figure out her body movement, but when she throws, she's doing a good job. Oh, superwoman punch.
Superwoman punch off the fence there.
Credit to Mauro Ranallo.
No. Keep
your feet on the floor.
Let's be basic.
Keep your feet on the floor. Pressure, Andrew, pressure. Jab. Jab right here, jab.
What are you waiting on? What are you waiting on? Pull the trigger.
Corner of Lee asking what she's waiting for, wanting a little more pressure here. Definitely feeling out process. Both women very talented.
There you go.
Throwing with a lot of heat, though.
Where's the leg kick? Where's that leg kick at?
Oof.
There you go. Stay up, though.
Over the halfway point here of this first round, Andrea Lee really making Rachael Ostovich fight her fight.
She is, and she's using her length very, very well. You know, with those kicks, she's able to keep her out of range. I would expect more front kicks from her, but I'm liking what she's doing. Oh, nice inside trip.
Ostovich loaded up on that kick, and that was enough for Lee to trip her down. Nice little axe kick to the body there by Andrea Lee. Ostovich might be hurt. Hard left hand by Lee.
Goodness.
Ostovich covering up. Right hands here by Andrea Lee.
Oh!
Takes the back. Beautiful. Done.
Exactly
wow.
How you called.
In an instant there.
Look at the scramble here, though. Ostovich is not going to give up. Trying for her flip. Ostovich's hands are not active enough in that clinch. She's trying to do things without actually setting them up with her hands.
Another kick there by Andrea Lee.
I think those body shots really damaged her, TJ.
Followed up with a nice punch to the face as well on Ostovich. Touch over a minute here in the first. Punch and a kick combination by Andrea Lee. Nice little switch kick there by KGB.
I think she's coming up top very, very shortly with that leg. Look at the way she's brought Ostovich's hands down lower.
Credit to Ostovich, she looked like she was hurt. Now she's, you know, cleared the cobwebs for the time being.
Cleared the cobwebs, but she looks gassed. It could be a strategy.
Oh, spinning back fist by Rachael Ostovich.
It was a strategy.
Wow. I don't know. That hurt her to the body. Rachael Ostovich is in trouble. 20 seconds left in the clock.
The body on the ground. Very, very hard to defend and very, very damaging.
10 seconds here.
You can look. Ostovich is still trying to toss her. Lee
going
jumps
for the rear
her
naked
back.
Choke. Time might run out here. This is deep. Time expires. I've got to think, Julie, if there was 5 seconds left in the clock. Touch of gloves. Lee back in the center.
Ostovich is on her toes again, so she must have recovered her breath there. Lee again looking like she's stalking her down, just with feints.
Spinning back kick misses for Ostovich. Lee answers with a kick.
You gotta use your jab, baby. Everything comes off the jab.
Set it up, set it up. Forget about the body. Go for two to the body. Eight to the body if you can.
Saw Andrea Lee put a lot of strikes targeting the body of Ostovich. We'll see if she can do that.
Oh, beautiful again. She gave her a thumbs up.
Now a kick there from Ostovich.
Looks like Ostovich has come awake in this round.
Having a little bit more fun on the feet is Rachael Ostovich.
Oh, looking for a side kick right there.
Coming from a variety of angles. Andrea Lee very capable of doing that. We saw the Superman punch again missed there by Rachael Ostovich.
There you go. Work the jab, Andrea. Work the jab. Work the jab, Andrea. Good. Good. Follow up. 2-3-2. Leg kick. Leg kick. 1-2-3-2.
Another attempt, left hook to the body there by Lee, nothing there though.
And watch the way Lee moves with her feet. The way she steps, her right foot propels her forward. She's pushing off her right foot. It's very nice in footwork. She's bouncing, 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 and then she'll step and then push forward to get that power strike. It always keeps her light on her feet.
Nice right hand there by Ostovich. Nice kick punch combination there from Ostovich.
Let your hands go right now.
Corner of Lee begging her to let her hands go. She comes to the body. Hard right hand gets through, too.
Very nice. That body shot hurt again.
Rachael Ostovich moving, though. Now she's got a spinning back, and that landed nicely, Julie. Another kick by Andrea Lee.
The problem with Ostovich is one-stop hits. They're hitting nicely, but they're not really accumulating.
Lunging left hook there by Andrea Lee. She loads up in the kick to the lead leg there of Ostovich. Lee definitely mixing up her kicks this round.
Keep your hands up. Hands up high. Against the cage.
We have yet to see Rachael Ostovich really try to use her judo inside the clinch.
Oh, jab put her down.
Andrea Lee. Now Lee's going to try to take the back again. Look at Ostovich, maybe fishing for a knee bar there.
Looks like it, yeah.
Lee now getting a takedown. We saw this in the final moments of round number one. Lee nearly ended this thing with a rear naked choke. We'll see if she tries to take the back and get in the hooks.
Ostovich just trying to keep her hands locked up right there, trying to keep Lee from getting those underhooks. Unfortunately, she's not able to. Really pinning those hands down, trying to toss her almost from the ground and stop her assault.
90 seconds here remain in round two. Ostovich back to her feet.
Whoa, oh. There's the judo attempt.
And she's really wise to it, though.
Ostovich is in a really interesting position. I don't think Lee could actually get her hooks in on Ostovich's left leg. It's completely extended. Now she's pulled it back in, but that interesting. It's almost like doing a half split. Knees to the butt can actually hurt, TJ. Those knees right there, they can hit a nerve, and it makes it really, really hard for you to actually walk.
Yeah, it doesn't look fun.
No.
We saw Ostovich in this position with her fight with Evan Johnson. She was able to get out of it then. She gets out of it now again.
Ostovich's costume is working against her as well. That strap is coming down and it's distracting her. I really admire the creativity of these girls, but you have to account for what's going to happen in a fight and the movement.
Andrea Lee putting it on Rachael Ostovich. Nice 1-2 combination.
Oh, nice.
Now Ostovich circles or tries to circle off the fence. 30 seconds remain here.
Oh,
nice high
nice
kick there.
Done.
Rachael Ostovich still in this one, but definitely took a hard left head kick.
And I'm guessing Omaha means bringing her to the ground, dragging her down from her back. Ah, oh, very nice lateral trip. That's one of my favorite throws, and that was just beautifully done, textbook.
Now Andrea Lee trying to finish one of the final moments of round number two, this time with strikes. She's going to run out of time. Ostovich covers up, and we are headed to round number three.
Into a dominant position, and she's got to finish now.
Touch of gloves, final 5 minutes here between these two flyweights. It's Andrea Lee taking that center point of the cage. Nice kick to the body there. Ostovich wisely moving away.
She's ready to fold, Andrea. She's ready to go down. Back to being cut the ring off, don't follow.
Nice left hand there and a body kick. Got to admire Lee finishing those combinations with the kick to the body. Look at that, though. Ostovich gets what she needs.
Now she's in half. That was exactly what she needed to do. Now, Andrea Lee is no slouch on the ground. We saw that on her back. We saw that in her fight with Roxanne Modafferi. However, I think this is where Ostovich can get more success.
Lee almost got a sweep, which forced Ostovich to bail on the position. Now back on her feet.
So much for my prediction of success there.
Looks like Ostovich might be cut there on the right side of her scalp. That's bleeding pretty good. Left knee to the body there by Lee. Ostovich covering up.
Oh,
she might be hurt
wow.
here. Andrea Lee might be able to finish this.
Those are fantastic knees. Oh, she shoots for a single. Right into the knee, right into the power that's coming in here. That woman has so much heart.
I'm not sure if it's the cut. Wow. Oh, beautiful stuff here. Ostovich trying to secure this takedown. I don't know if it was the blood that was running in the eye of Ostovich or if she's hurt, but that cut definitely impairing the ability here of Rachael Ostovich, but now she's on top of Andrea Lee.
She has top position, and her arm is actually dragged underneath. She's a little bit tied up from the top position, but she's transitioning almost all the way to full mount.
Got to make sure she doesn't get too high. She's going to lose the position. She might be able to adjust here, unable to.
She did get too high. Andrea Lee read that beautifully, just came right out the back door.
back to where she can throw her attacks.
You see the crimson mask there of Rachael Ostovich.
Look at Ostovich trying for that leg lock. I think she's trying for an inside heel hook. I'm not able to see right there. Leah's reading that and grabbing onto her head and forcing the pressure back down.
She gets her leg free. Now Ostovich trying for an armbar. Rachael Ostovich battered in bloody, but still not out of this.
Well, I'm pretty sure she will have to be tapped or knocked out to actually stop working. I don't think she's going to quit.
Under 2.5 here, we see some elbows from Andrea Lee.
And given Lee's physique, look how pointy her elbows are. She can really, really wreak havoc with those.
Andrea Lee biding her time here. Now Ostovich goes belly down.
Again, giving up her back. This time Lee has enough time to work to get that finish.
Andrea Lee digging with the left arm.
Keeping her flat is a great strategy. She needs to work that cut now. She needs to really dig into it.
Both hooks in here now for Andrea Lee. Touch under a minute 45 here in round number 3. Lee postures up, nice hammer fist to the left side of Ostovich's face.
Lee is still working, but she's very, very much completely on the defense now.
See Lee getting a half Nelson grab here.
I feel like Lee is going to be trying for that armbar. Well, I did think that, but I think Ostovich is still making it difficult for her to actually execute the submission. Oh, there she is on her back again, pulling it through.
It's a very nice showcase through 3 rounds here by Andrea Lee, trying to get it finished. One minute remains here.
Andrea's corner was calling for a face choke, although I still think it looks like she's setting up that arm bar right there. A face choke, putting pressure on the face, would be a nice way to make that bleed more, make things very, very uncomfortable.
Rachael Ostovich is anything but comfortable at this point. 30 seconds remain, Andrea Lee. Rachael Ostovich, a gymnast and a cheerleader in her past, definitely showing off the flexibility there, but unable to break free of Andrea Lee. Ostovich goes belly down once again, final 15 seconds here. Ostovich trying to shake her off. She might, she gotta make sure she doesn't get caught in an arm bar when she does. Looks like we are gonna go the distance here, but there we go, that's a wrap. 15 minutes in the books.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at the official time. 4 minutes, 58 seconds, round number 3. Submission by armbar for your winner, Shreveport Bossier, Louisiana's own, Andrea KGB Lee!
Andrea Lee gets it done. Our Laura Sanko speaks with KGB.
Ladies and gentlemen, the action continues here at the Hangar in Costa Mesa, California. Our next bout is scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds and is in the flyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This boxing style fighter stands 5'6" tall, official weight 125 1/4 pounds. She has a professional record of 4 wins and 2 losses. One of her wins coming by way of decision and 2 by knockout. From Butte, Montana, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Ariel Sunshine Beck. And now let's welcome her opponent, fighting across the cage out of the red corner. This mixed martial artist stands 5'3" tall, official weight 125 1/2 pounds. She has a professional record of 2 wins and 2 losses. One of her wins coming by way of submission and 1 by decision. From Waianae, Hawaii, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Rachael Ostovich. The referee in charge of the action, Herb Dean.
The veteran Herb Dean getting this flyweight assignment. It is Ariel Beck making her Invicta FC debut, and Rachael Ostovich.
Ready, fight. Ready. Good. go. Touching gloves. We are underway. Back in the black, Ostovich wearing the Wonder Woman getup. Enjoy live and exclusive events, original programming, and the largest MMA library on UFC Fight Pass. Download the UFC.tv app today, anytime, anywhere. Your pass to the Ultimate Fighting Championship.
You're seeing some ultimately long, strong punches. Ostovich, she's extending on those. She really wants to hit hard.
Primarily a grappler on paper. Ostovich said she worked on striking for this fight. So the head movement, the pawn jab there.
You know, when you're facing a southpaw boxer, which I've had some experience, very much experience sparring for, it's hard to find that angle. You really want to move, you know, the way you're used to moving, with your right foot first, moving to your right. You have to start moving to your left. You have to keep your left foot on the outside of her right foot.
Back with a nice kick to the lead leg of Ostovich. Ostovich comes high with the right kick that misses. A lot of movement here by Ostovich early, but Beck, a very dangerous striker.
She is, but she doesn't seem to have opened up yet. She seems very stiff to me, which is not to say those punches wouldn't hurt, but she's tentative.
You know, a lot is made about an orthodox fighter fighting a southpaw. What adjustments do you have to make as an orthodox fighter coming into a fight with a left-handed fighter?
Well, with the left-handed fighter, nice big shots.
Those shots turn also into a grappler. She tries to get a takedown, now clinched up. A lot of judo in the background of Ostovich. Right now, that's put on hold by a nice knee to the body. Now a clinch up against the cage.
Yeah, you know, earlier when I said she was fighting stiff, it seems that she's actually able from that tall posture to deliver power from hips that don't seem to be moving as much. That's the mark of some experience.
Trying to land some strikes there off the fence. They break back into space, still clinched up. Nice right hand on right by Ariel Beck.
Ostovich really has to outstep back. If she wants that takedown so badly, she's got to outstep the rusher just like that and change levels.
We talked to Ostovich about his game plan here. She said that she was going to call on any skills necessary to get it done, but right now she's playing the game Ariel Beck. Nice kick to the body there by Ostovich.
I have to say flyweight is one of my favorite divisions to watch in that they really want to hurt each other.
Speed always on display from flyweights. Technique very well, very good as well.
And we'll be seeing a flyweight debut in the UFC coming up very soon. Valerie Vitorino and Joanne Calderwood, an Invicta Fights vet.
Ostovich with a spinning leg kick. Hard shots here by Ariel Beck. Ostovich now getting back to that clinch game. Control back against the fence now.
Look at the way she's hooking her leg with her left. She's trying to do that to pull her down, force her down to the ground. She did a good job of loading up for that knee, you know, understanding she wasn't able to get the throw right there and using her leverage to get that knee. Those elbows look nice.
Ostovich really sticking to this clinch here, trying to get a takedown.
The problem with Ostovich's attack here is it's strong, and her technique is not bad, but it's almost bullying, and it's not working against Beck. Beck is very technical. She's hitting some really hard shots on the outside there.
Hard shots have been knees to the body. Ostovich not liking it, brought up her leg a moment ago to try to block it. Now we're back at space. Now we'll see if Beck opens up a bit more. She was tentative early, but she's had a lot of success here with her strikes. Oh, nice little counter shot there by Ariel Beck gets through. 45 seconds here. Nice kick in a left hand by Beck. Superman punch gets through. Nice overhand response. Rushing back into the clinch now.
Ostovich did a very nice job of going shot to reshot right there, but she wasn't able to get the takedown. But I think that hand actually hit the right hand.
Beck landing a nice standing elbow there a moment ago. She is vicious with these knees up against the cage.
She really is, and that was very well done. Her knee, right knee was being blocked out. She still picked it up to throw.
The shoulder shrugs there a moment ago. Ostovich grimacing. Now framing up a guillotine. The time is not the Hawaiian's friend right now. Final seconds. We're 5 minutes into the fifth. Nice round for aerial back. Strikes, striking confidently, and when Ostovich has tried to get that takedown, it hasn't been there.
Yep, I'm outside.
Round number two underway.
Let's open up with that left. Double that left up, Ariel. Head in body. Double that left.
You look at the wide stance of Ostovich, the way she's moving. You can tell she wants to generate power for that shot or for her punch. Unfortunately, with the tallness that Beck has, it's easier for her to defend on that. Oh, look at this judo attempt.
She's trying now. She might go to a knee bar. Ostovich has that right leg isolated very well. Beck, she's trying to get a heel hook. Beck trying to fight the legs here. Is that the key to get out of this position?
It is. What she needs to do is strip Ostovich's right leg over the top. She's just make her legs come apart. Strip them from time and control. Beautifully done right there. Her heel is still in there, but her knee is not completely trapped. It's in there a bit, but I think she can muscle her way out of this. One of the things she really needs to do on this is also trap the hips, control the hips of somebody that are trying to leg lock her.
For Ostovich, you need to know the right time to bail and move so you don't need a lot of punches.
She's very flexible right here, which is good, but she's also in a position to get some damage.
We've seen that flexibility on display in the past from Ostovich, a gymnast, but that doesn't help her here from this offensive onslaught from Ariel Beck. And we'll see if Beck wants to stand up. You see Ostovich trying to pivot off, maybe frame up an armbar on the left arm of Ariel Beck.
And look at the way Ostovich's left leg is caught underneath. She's not going to be able to get that armbar very well. However, we saw actually Michelle Watterson land that armbar with her leg trapped against Jessica Penning. So it can be done. It's just really hard.
Still in half guard, but Beck has isolated that left arm with her leg. Flirting with the key lock, now some elbows. Rachael Ostovich is in a world of trouble here.
She is, and she rolled a little bit the wrong way, I think, right there, right to give up her back. She should have rocked back and forth. Well, she's back on her feet, though.
Beck lost the position, but she's back in the world on the feet, and Rachael Ostovich may be hurt, but she's still game. Kick to the body by the Hawaiian.
You can see that up. Ariel Beck is actually breathing out of her mouth quite a bit right here, but I don't think her gas tank is suffering.
A right hand into a shot block. Nicely done.
That's the kind of chaining together of combinations that she needs to do to be more successful against the taller fighter.
Half butterfly here for Beck. Ostovich immediately tried to pass the guard, but Beck able to keep her inside that guard. Touch under 2.5 minutes for Ostovich to work here.
And Ostovich has shown she has a very good base, but unfortunately that's not a super great attacking position unless she gets a good posture to rain punches from or elbows.
We talked game plan with Rachael Ostovich yesterday. This is the game plan she wanted on paper, finally getting to it here in the second round.
Because look at the way Beck was able to insert her leg there, but Ostovich's base, like I said, it's good. She's able to use that leg insertion to get past to have her.
Beck has a power through, but she gives up her back in the process. Ostovich has one hook in, trying to get a right one in, and she does. 90 seconds is a long time to be back about it by Rachael Ostovich.
It is. She's trying for that rear naked choke. It looks like her arm is underneath. I can't quite see the angle, but it looks like it got under the chin.
Going palm to palm right now, trying to dig that left arm under.
She's flattening her out, smart.
Ostovich taking her time.
But she's a little high in that back. Ariel Beck can't get out the back door there. She applies her hips a little bit stronger.
Ostovich really trying to get this rear naked.
Oh, she's got her over her face. That's a pain move. It can hurt her jaw very much, but it's also easier to strip an arm off of your face than from your neck.
Ariel Beck, a grinder, is trying to grind through this position right now.
Keep working.
45 legs here. Maybe going for the arm is Ostovich.
And you can see Ariel Beck's working hard for that grip. She can feel the armbar attempt coming.
Is Ostovich in the right position to try to get the left leg over Beck's face?
You know, I would abandon trying to break the grip right there and actually roll through the belly down armbar. You know, try, I mean, it's a, she's belly up in there.
So she can get that arm extended. 15 seconds left in the second round. Ariel Beck trying to survive. Ostovich really trying to get it out here on the run. Trying to separate.
She's kind of lost a position of leverage right.
time to push down. She needs to fight.
She doesn't get the submission, but she gets a nice close for her. Ariel Beck showed her skills in the first round. Rachael Ostovich showed hers in the second. Round number three. Underway, a very important round here between these two flyweights. Beck pawing again with that jab. Ostovich coming in with the rush of punches. You know, that's how she got that takedown. We'll see if she comes again with that overhand right and try to just go right into a double leg.
Yeah, the way Ostovich has to win this fight is by a barrage of punches to a takedown. She can't do these little exchanges because obviously Ariel Beck is looking for shots off of the shot, counter fighting.
And she's landing some hard strikes here. Ariel Beck punching him up. Ostovich shoots in. Desperation takedown here. Beck sprawls wisely.
And she's trying to pull a butterfly guard right here, but it's not a great thing for her to do at the moment. With Beck on top of her, delivering up. Beck lets her up.
Smart move by Beck. She definitely had. Ostovich hurt. Doesn't want to go down to her role, though. And credit to Beck, too. She was in some danger in the second round, but moral victory, maybe some confidence on the floor as well. Ostovich had some danger and wasn't able to finish. Oh, beautiful knee there by Beck.
That looked very powerful. You know, I am extremely envious of Ariel Beck's ability. It's so cool.
Rachael Ostovich is on the run right now, Julie. She goes to her back.
And you don't lay on your back with your hands over your head like that, guys. At home. You have to be aggressive from right there.
Molly in looking position here for Ariel Beck. We'll see if she lets Rachael stand back up and kick to the leg.
Those knee shots are very nice, but they're not aggressive enough for her to get anything going on offense.
Ostovich stands up. A lot of time here, 3 minutes left in the fight.
And I don't think Ostovich has any intention of quitting. I don't think, you know, she's going to be leaving this fight with anything but giving her entire gas tank.
Ostovich coming with the double jab there. Back really biding her time. Ostovich coming forward. Going with the jab. Going with the other way.
I feel like in her attack, if Ariel Beck were to throw a left uppercut, she might land something really nice right there. She might be able to I guess, get her on her
missile. Right hand misses by Ostovich. But Rachael throws, she almost gets off kilter with the power if she misses.
She does. That's that kind of, I want to knock somebody out, I want to cause damage, but I'm sacrificing a little bit of my balance to do so.
Don't let her rest. Let's go. Corner of Beck telling her to not let Ostovich rest. Hard punch to the body there by Ostovich. Nicely done.
That was a good read. Hard strike after a hard strike. Get
outside that foot. Outside that foot. Leave with your left. Outside the foot. Leave with your left.
Ostovich definitely getting aggressive here in these final 2 minutes. Get a takedown. She go a long way here. There she goes. That same shot that she tried. Gets it done. This could go a long way for Rachael Ostovich. Touch over 90 seconds here in this final round.
Great way to take control of what she wants to do in the fight after being dropped early on.
Some blood, I believe, is coming from the nose of Ariel Beck. And the right hand has been nice for the takedown. I think it landed that time, and now Ostovich trying to clear the guard.
You know,
hard punches here for Rachael Ostovich.
And she's got the off track, just as Beck did to her. As much as you'd say, Ostovich is off her balance on her striking feet. She has supreme balance.
Ostovich going for an Americana here. Beck trying to move. Fighting it for now. She moves to the other side, does Ostovich. Now back in a half guard. 50 seconds remaining. Ariel Beck trying to stand. Guillotine coming for Rachael Ostovich.
I don't know that it's on her. Look at the way she's able to brace out of it. If I were Ostovich, I would definitely be switching to attacking those arms and face on the mat.
Beck might be working a little bit there. Ostovich brings that guard up high, definitely securing the position.
Oh, she's so again. Excuse me, I didn't see that angle.
It's a nice adjustment, Julie, but she loses it. Now Ariel Beck on top.
And now she's on her back. She's on the
stand. Ostovich. Beck cleans the legs, punches by Ariel Beck. She does. Not enough time to secure the position. Ariel Beck is very lucky she didn't land that kick.
Very lucky. That was an illegal kick. If that landed, that could have stopped the fight completely.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of mixed martial arts action, we go to the judges' scorecards, and we have a split decision. Judge Jackie Denkin scores the bout 29-28. She sees it for Ostovich. Judge Michael Bell scores the bout 29-28. He sees it for Beck. And Judge Ron McCarthy scores the bout 29-28. For your winner by split decision, Rachael Ostovich!
Rachael Ostovich gets it done. Split decision. I gotta assume it was that late takedown with that offense and that submission attempt.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, live on UFC Fight Pass from the Scottish Rite Temple here in beautiful Kansas City, Missouri. A very good evening, and welcome to an exciting night of women's professional mixed martial arts for your enjoyment. This is Invicta FC. And we are set to go with our first bout tonight. Three rounds, this in the flyweight division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner. Standing 5 feet, 5 inches tall, she weighed an officially 125 and one-third pounds. Tonight, she makes her MMA debut fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada. Here is Christine Misfit Ferreira! And across the cage stands her opponent fighting out of the red corner. At 5 feet, 3 inches tall, she weighed in at the flyweight limit, 126 pounds. Her professional record in five bouts stands at 3 victories and 2 defeats. Fighting out of Waianae, Hawaii, here is Rachael Ostovich Burnham! And your referee in charge of the action is Mike England.
Flyweights in the cage. It is Christine Ferreira making her Invicta FC debut against Rachael Ostovich Burnham. Mike England getting this assignment. Touch gloves, we're underway. UFC 208 is live from Brooklyn on Saturday, February 11th, where the main event will feature the inaugural Women's Featherweight Championships as former Bantamweight champion Holly Holm takes on the Dutch striking specialist Jermaine Durandamy. It's UFC 208 from Barclays Center in Brooklyn, New York. It's only on pay-per-view. See Ferreira come high with a kick. Gets the kick in early.
Bit of a trade of kicks there. If you notice Ferreira's eyes, she's delivering her mouth down, trying to get Ostovich to think she's doing a low kick. She's done that several times, looked down hard, and then thrown a high kick.
That is a skill that is achieved over many years of Muay Thai. Get a fighter thinking one way, and actually, you make that decision. Mirko Krokop always said he could do that as he was throwing the kick. Mid-kick, switch it, bring it low, bring it high, wherever you weren't defending. Ferreira with the jab there.
Yeah, it's interesting to see, you know, Ostovich Burdan is playing the stand-up game right now. She's not immediately going into the shot, but she's looking for an opportunity to move her straight on her feet.
Of course, you can weigh in on Twitter tonight. Get at us at TJ Casanis, at Jules K underscore fighter, hashtag Invicta FC 21. Of course, at Invicta Fights as well.
Step into your right.
With punches and kicks. Ostovich with that grappling background. She still has to test herself, though. She's been away for a little while. She didn't get as many fights as she wanted to in 2017, or 2016, rather. Maybe tonight wants to show some super striking ability.
And if you notice the movement of Ferreira right now, she keeps that left hand very, very low, but her chin is tucked behind her right hand. Also, her left shoulder.
Ostovich hit her with her right hand, got on the inside, now working the clinch. This is where we thought that the fight maybe very interesting. To utilize that clinch, but it's Ostovich pushing her up against the back.
We do know Ostovich went for that single double. Now she's trying to get back to that single leg. Oh, and trying for her judo. Unfortunately, not in the best position to execute that with her hips.
Ostovich now on her back. We'll see if Ferreira wants to engage her here. Nope, she welcomes her back to the feet.
That's one way to get him back up. I like the confidence of Ferreira right now. She's not going to play another person's game here.
Some experience on display there from Ferreira, despite this being her debut in pro mixed martial arts. You know, some fighters get overzealous with aggression, have their opponent on their back, and just go to the floor with them. It's wise for the Muay Thai fighter to keep that space and stay.
I think too. And if you notice also her posture, the way her feet are, her knees are quite bent. She's up and down, but she's switching stages. She's moving around a little bit. She's making clear adjustments from the art of Muay Thai into bringing it to MMA. That was a beautiful break to the kick. You know, sticking the hand out that aggressively is a little bit of a cage grab there. Let's see if she can still finish this takedown.
Ostovich really sold out on that overhand right, entering the shot. I think she's getting out there, kicking offense.
Yeah, I'm seeing those elbows. Are you seeing them from the 12-6 angle, or is she curving?
That's up to Mike England. It's always up to subjective viewers when it comes to that, but she does need to watch that.
Yeah, I'm not a huge fan of that rule. I think elbows can be elbows, but I understand you need to go by the rules. You need to follow what's going on. And look at the fight for inside control. Look at the way Korea's resting on her, but she's also putting her elbow to push out against Ostovich. That's very nice control.
Now back at space, Ostovich Bernard has had the clinch a few times, not able to really secure a takedown. There's a jab there, though. Very welcome to this firefight.
Please, you'll have to forgive me. I forgot that Ostovich has recently been here, so she's Ostovich Bernard. I'm trying to correct myself here.
Pick again land to the leg of Ostovich Bernard by Perez.
Come on, come on,
back at space here. Touch over 30 seconds remaining here in our opening round. Confidence booster, I think, for Perea here, being able to stay on the feet despite Ostovich trying to take it down. It's hard to overcome that wrestling and judo background. Ostovich, but Perea's done a nice job with that here earlier.
Yeah, when we talk about range control, I think, I think Perea was doing an excellent job of that. Oh, she hit Ostovich with her elbow right there behind her. I don't know if you saw that. That looked a little sharp.
Nice, now she's trying to secure this takedown. Final seconds here, round one. Ostovich Bernard trying to get it to the floor, unable to do so.
Perea around.
Perea getting very creative with these strikes. We'll see if she can implement that here in round number two, and what adjustments Ostovich Bernard has made in her corner. Perea has been changing the stances a few times here, now starting orthodox in round number two.
She has been, and if you notice, she just mimicked and threw a couple uppercuts. I think she's going to try and catch her on those double legs with an upper or an inside attack if Ostovich Bernard rushes her again.
Now back to southpaw is Perea. What does that do for the fighter that's looking at their opponent constantly change stances? It's got to mess with your head a bit.
Oh, I think so, especially when you want to get a read on them, you want to take them down. Now, obviously, your game plan and what you want to do depends on your execution of it, but you can't help but be cognizant when a fighter shifts an angle or doesn't give you what you've trained for. Nice kick.
Perea kind of dismissing it, kicks to the body. Ostovich coming high. Ostovich Bernard, you know, with her kicks, don't sleep on her as just a grappler. She does have the ability to trade with you, and not just punch. She can kickbox.
Yeah, she's a well-rounded MMA fighter, and she can use those exchanges to get with a fight where she wants to be. That was beautifully done, reading off of that and diving right in.
Perea gets to a base, but now has her back taken. One hook secure for Ostovich Bernard, and this is really Rachael Ostovich's world.
Yeah, she's a little bit like, I don't want to say, well, yeah, like a spider monkey. She's able to insert her feet around and crawl around an opponent and manipulate her body around theirs to get what she wants out of it.
You have to fear the skills here of Ostovich Bernard, but you also have to worry about how much time she has. And, you know, 3 minutes, 15 seconds, a lot of time for the Hawaiian to work.
It is. And for Perea, she needs to keep her calm right now. She's doing a good job of trying to get those hooks out by straightening out her leg and shaking it out. Ostovich Bernard, is cognizant. She knows what's going on. She knows that's happening. Look at the way Freya is going to push her up against the cage. Well, if she does push her back up against the cage, she can scrape her off.
Ostovich looked like he was trying to flatten out Perea, but instead punches, now trying to open up that rear naked choke.
And that's exactly what you need to do right there. You need to work your strikes in until you can insert your hooks and until you can get your submission. That's what ground and pound is for. Some of those might have got a little bit close to the neck there, but haven't had a call on that yet, so.
Ostovich Berdan landing some left hands here. Mike England taking a look at it. Ferreira does need to move, though. She can't stay here forever.
She does. It's important to be. That's the hard part about grappling. You have to be defensive while you're in motion. And a lot of the time that means protecting your neck, protecting your hooks while you're scrambling your feet around. Looks like she's sinking that rear naked choke, and I don't think it's all the way under the chin.
The crush could be enough here, though. Ostovich has a good grip. She loses it. 2 minutes remain here in round number two. Ostovich really trying to make a count.
Yeah, now Ostovich is a little bit high, but she's also got that that right hook inserted, so she's able to kind of use that for leverage. Her left leg also, I would preferably have her straighten that out just a little bit more, try to flatten Ferreira to get some more of that ground and pound.
Ferreira hanging tough for the time being, but it is all Rachael Ostovich here in round number two.
And look at the fight for the wrist control right there. That's pretty important. You can tell she's trying a transition. She's trying, oh yeah, she's trying to insert her foot in there. Lost her hook out of it, but it is it's a nice way to mess with somebody to really get control of their hands when they're trying to fight hands against a choke.
Ferreira's sticking her tongue. She knows she's in a fight. She's having some fun with it, but not a fun position here. Ostovich trying to sink in that forearm underneath the chin. Ferreira hanging tough, as I said, but that's a lot of power there for Ostovich Berdan.
Yeah, this is a pain move right here. It's really hard against the chin. It doesn't necessarily choke you out, but oh, she's playing a little bit right there, which is, that's fun, but she does need to work to improve her position. She can try to let Ostovich Berdan muscle herself out, exert too much strength, and maybe tire out her arms, but right there, nothing's being improved right there. So, I don't want to say stalemate because there's obviously somebody in a stronger position here.
Ferreira trying to explode into the guard there of Ostovich Berdan, unable to do so. Now the Hawaiian readjusts, has a body triangle.
Ferreira's, you know, launching some pretty hard strikes there, some pretty hard bruising punches to her back, behind her back, which is fun to watch.
Ferreira is a character. She just turned and turned to the camera, but now she's being defensive. Coming here for Rachael Ostovich Berdan. Dying seconds of round number two. Can Ferreira survive? Ostovich trying to readjust.
And from here, I would just, Ostovich needs to sweep. She needs to tilt her head forward. She needs to sweep and get that arm extended.
Time. Just the round Rachael Ostovich Berdan needed for round number two. I got this even through 10 minutes. Now we are headed to round number three. Final 5 minutes between Rachael Ostovich Berdan and Christine Ferreira.
Let's go, see, take your time.
Kick to the body there by Ostovich Berdan. UFC Fight Pass is free week and continues tomorrow, and the world's premier streaming service for combat sport brings you UFC Fight Night prelims live and exclusively from Phoenix.
We saw a big right hand and a takedown. Ferreira was able to get right back to her feet, but both of those fighters had good exchanges just now.
These flyweights have found themselves into a fight here. Third round action underway. Nice right hand gets through by Ferreira.
And something that's working against Ostovich is when she's throwing her attacks and her hitting, she needs to keep moving forward. When she backs up, she gives Ferreira the space to move forward. Ferreira is very much a stalker. She pushes forward with her attacks. She's in and out, but she's always getting that constant pressure forward.
Ferreira aggressive here early. Ostovich.
Oh, beautiful kick.
It's a hard left hand. High kick. Ostovich might be out. Ferreira trying to make it count.
Goodness.
Ostovich going for the takedown. Ferreira landing some right hands. Mike England on top of it. Elbows to the body here.
I think she's out of this.
Fighting on pure instinct, not really defending herself. Ostovich now.
She's holding her leg right now, TJ, but I don't think she's conscious.
Ferreira still landing some punishment. Mike England has seen enough. Beautifully done by Christine Ferreira. She stops Rachael Ostovich in her Invicta FC debut.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at the official time. 1 minute, 29 seconds. Round number three, referee Mike England steps in, puts a halt to this bout. Your winner by TKO, Christine Misfit Ferreira.
Christine Ferreira by TKO. She gets Rachael Ostovich Berdan out of there.